It's the new health epidemic.
Anyone who's driven past the bus stops before and after school and seen the way that vaping is spreading amongst our young people, these are incredibly concerning developments.
In just 3 years, e-cigarette use has doubled. More than one third of regular users under 25.
You didn't know? The kindergartners are like the biggest vapers at this school.
Try some gummy bear surprise.
While daily smoking rates have plummeted, now down to just 11%.
If you smoke, you could grow up to be a failure.
Collapsing tobacco sales reportedly costing the government about $5 billion in taxes.
This is a problem for the budget, but much, much more importantly than that, this is a problem for our society.
Read the tobacco leaves, and some say tougher taxes on vapes could be looming.
The status quo is unacceptable. All options are on the table.
Meanwhile, the UK is taking an entirely different approach, announcing it will hand out vapes to 1 million smokers for free. But some aren't so keen on the Brits' approach.
Posting e-cigarettes and vaping kits out to people in a situation where we're facing a deluge of vaping in young Australians doesn't sound like a great idea to us.
So, with the vaping black market booming,
many of these vapes have actually got nicotine in them, and they're hooking a new generation of Aussie kids on inhaling chemicals.
And the long-term effects still unclear, which way is the right way to break our addiction?
Public health expert Dr. Sandro Demaio joins us now. Sandro, do you think tougher taxes is a good idea?
Well, so taxes have been used specifically for cigarettes in the past. We know that increasing taxes will reduce consumption, but we can't be using that alone. You know, we've spent 60 years undoing the damage of making cigarettes a consumer product, letting them leash on the market, which is what, you know, many front groups and even parts of politics are calling for. But that would be a disaster for public health. So, you know, taxes can be part of the puzzle, but really what we need to do is make sure that we're stopping the enormous number of, you know, single-use, highly addictive, toxic products coming across the border through border controls and enforcing the system we have. If taxes are part of that, fine, but it's certainly not going to solve the problem.
Right, that's the point, isn't it? I mean, most people, if we're honest, who are vaping are using a product that is effectively in a kind of black market. So even if you had taxes, how would that stop just about anybody from having the vapes that they're having?
Well, it wouldn't. And, you know, the black market wouldn't be subject to those taxes. I mean, the industry have created this black market. The tobacco industry, the vaping industry have created this black market, have flooded the Australian you know, market with cheap imports. They've done this in multiple countries. And it's a purposeful ploy to try and get the Australian community and politicians to throw their hands up and say, oh, it's all too hard, let's just make it a free-for-all. We can't follow that path. We will end up with another generation addicted to tobacco and spend the next 50 years cleaning up the mess as we did with cigarettes.
The UK has a very different approach to this. They're handing out vapes for free, including to pregnant women. Do you think that's a good idea?
No, I absolutely don't think it's a good idea. I mean, look, the UK need to do what's right for them. Here in Australia, we have some of the lowest smoking rates in the world. We're a world leader in tobacco control. And we have a system here in Australia that if you currently smoke, like a truckie I met just this morning in regional Victoria, smoked for 50 years, he is able, through a prescription, with advice from his doctor, to get access to e-cigarettes as a last line you know, effort to be able to quit smoking. Because there are safer ways of quitting smoking, including patches, chewing gum and other measures. So there are pathways in Australia that they don't have in the UK. I personally, based on the evidence, think they're much smarter, certainly for us in our context. But we need to do what's right for us here in Australia and for the Australian context, and most importantly, for young Australians.
Sandro, thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.